pop, and its nasal cavity explodes with blood. It seems to waver and wane as light shines out from its eye sockets, and miraculously, it still has not died.
Sess, roll a d8.
Yeah, Morris, we're more or less just started. I just exploded this guy out of the wraith.
Another two damage. Yeah.
Oh, that'll do it. That'll kill him. No, I'm joking.
Well, if it's up to
20. Nope, you still got 4 hit points, and I will milk this for all it's worth.
Why did I ever roll a 2?
That said, from Thunder and Ivor over to me, and in his last ditch moment.
Now he teleports.
Sir, no shit, eh? Nope, he gains 5 hit points, first off. Aha!
And then he makes goo angels.
Yeah, right, hey.
Does he cower in submission so he isn't banished back to the abyss?
No, what I should do is, like, I could have tried to drown you in the fluid. That would have been funny.
You heal 5 hit points. You drown,
right? At the same time. You keep stabilizing while dying. It'd be weird.
It's kind of like when I'm stuck on a spike.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, yeah. What is he gonna do? Is he just gonna boring wise attack? Ah, fuck it. He's just gonna boring wise attack and do a shit ton of damage while he does it. So the Jack in the Box strikes once again.
Same spike.
Oh, fuck, no, that's right. What?
Oh, because, he did attack. Never mind. It's gone.
Oh, okay, never mind. Sorry, your AC is 19?
Paul.
Thrasix is 19 AC?
No, 17.
Oh, 17. Okay, 18 hits you then. And 11 plus another 10 is 21, and then 13 again is going to hit you. He continues his relentless assault into you. And then at the last minute, I guess he'll bite into you, actually.
Okay.
So, just for dramatic effect, why not? I've been doing
it. AC is like 39, so good luck. What did you roll, dude?
Shit, man. What did
23 was the last one I heard, so. 13 plus 10.
I don't remember.
Let's roll again.
No, I'll use the middle one, which I know is a 27.
27.
So he claws you for 27. Is that it?
For it, sir.
Okay.
I don't have a buff bottom.
Cool. Don't worry. It's only 3d6, that one.
Yeah.
I'm sure you can take it.
Oh, no,
for the kingdom. For the kingdom. So you can take 11 or half of if you're still raging. You can take 13 like a man.
If he's biting, do you have acid blood?
And then he will bite back into thoracics for 30, which is going to be 15. So 14 and 15 for 29 total that thoracics does take. That is halved. 29? 29 total, yes.
Yeah, you fucked up.
With that said, the talons chew into you. His tusks chew into you. As his claw strikes upon you and you, and the camera's swiveling down to Thrasix, who does what?
Does he still have me up in the air?
He doesn't really even have you in the air. You're standing your ground, he's got you forked, he's still trying to shoot
well,
you off.
One.
Oh, shit! That sucks, bro! Oh my gosh, confirm it.
I don't even know what am I using.
I was just gonna make you slip in the
fluid.
Oh,
hand.
By the way, gain 5 hit points.
I got an empty hand.
Regenerate 5 hit points, by the way.
You get your dwarven.
I'm
afraid
one.
Your pistol's the only thing you're equipped here
so
at the moment.
40. Still have another attack. What happened to
one?
I did. I rolled an 18.
Oh.
I guess I got other guns up here. I pull my other gun. Capping them.
Alright, sweet. So, slipping in the fluid.
What happens with the one?
That's what I'm getting at. Right. Slipping in the fluid as you're gaining 5 hit points, everything goes slow. Ivor in the background, cocks his gun. Vayne prepares another firebolt. Thunder cocks her gun. And you crack down on the ground, your gun crack into the ground next to you, and you sit there dazed as this beast comes flying down to claw into you. As you take your d6 of damage for the fall, which is 6 points actually, a little trickle of blood seeps into the fluid behind you, the wound quickly sealing against the viscosity. As it comes down upon you, its massive massive tusks, massive fangs, huge talons, all pointed, ready to chew upon your flesh and crush your bones. Your gun enters your frame almost instinctually and unleashes. One bullet that finds its way down its gullet, ending the entirety of it as it collapses in a heap next to you, landing where your gun arm was. It splays out its talon arm almost resting upon you as though it wanted to spoon. The camera kind of rotates slowly away from you overhead as it shows you laying on the ground, your chest heaving as you take the moment to breathe once again. It sits lifeless next to you.
I'm like, oh, I'm like, I don't know what this is going to happen, but I'm not going to call you. I get up.
And with that, as it lands in a heap next to you there, the fluid canister sits idle, its body slumped, 1 foot still sitting against the glass edge.
I'm gonna hit you for 23.
23?
Yeah.
Is that a touch?
I would cast it as a touch, yeah.
Okay, so as you walk into the puddle up next to him, you gain 5 hit points.
Do I get another 5 hit points for still being in there?
Yep.
Okay,
yeah.
So I'm like, oh, that seems to be healing up.
Let's have our long rest in this puddle.
Everybody
just sleep
in the puddle.
I stay in the puddle until I get
full. Yep.
Which is only 4 rounds.
That's fine. Every round you're gaining 5 hit points.
Sweet.
Is this the liquid that came from the container?
Yep.
Does anybody have a bottle we can collect some of this stuff?
Yes. Yes, we do.
Alright.
And I'm going to assume that Alongi is going to collect some as well.
Alongi is completely passed out.
Okay.
She's gone.
That is completely okay. We're gonna hand wave that all together.
Does she have any magic items on her?
She doesn't seem to have a corporeal form.
Oh.
Do you want to spend the entire session metagaming trying to touch her?
I can kill incorporeal creatures, it's fine. Okay.
Take tantric possession, hentai. Oh god.
I'm actually gonna dump one of my. Or does anybody want to drink this healing potion? Because I want the bottle.
I'll drink it.
1d8
plus 1. 1d8
plus 1. And then I'm gonna.
Oh, eight. Yeah!
Nice.
I need that.
And then I'm gonna fill the bottle with that green shit.
So,
nice.
Talking about, but I know with all the celebrities right now, they're getting harassed for sexual harassment.
It is
and in a lot of the situations that I've read, it's just like, give me a fucking break.
But
like Dustin Hoffman.
He was
25 years ago, he's getting fucking shit for grabbing some chick's ass. Like, come on, fuck.
Kevin Spacey, he was like, I don't remember it happening because I was really, he's like, I was really drunk and I don't remember it happening. But if it did, I'm sorry. That
what
was what he
and
said.
What did he do?
It was like a 17-year-old kid or something. He made sexual advantages on his bed or something.
He made sexual advantages on a 17-year-old and he was like in his 20s.
Oh.
Or something. Or no, 14-year-old. He was
14. Yeah,
that was very...
A little young.
But yeah,
that's
basically...
That's
literally going back 30 years here.
Probably.
Yeah, but there's more. Now everyone's coming out and saying that they have their own stories.
Ever since the Weinstein thing.
But he also came out and used that in this.
You know.
He did, yeah. And then he got under fire for everybody as like.
There should be a rule about
this. You know, check this out.
Statue of Limitations.
Now, if it was some kid that was 14-year-old kid, and he was banging fucking Jessica Alba, whatever her name is, when she was 21, everybody would be like,
nothing bad would happen. You'd get congratulated.
Yeah, he'd be getting a fucking pat on the back, good job,
and
high five. But if it's a girl, everybody's like, oh.
Yeah, but then she would be called a slut and a whore and disgusting.
She'd be called a molester and arrested.
What?
Yeah, then there's that side of it.
Why would
she
call a slut and a whore, though? I don't get that part.
Because that's what people do when women do something wrong, is they call them sluts and whores.
Well, I don't know.
It's for the same reason that mansplaining exists, right? When a woman doesn't know, every guy in the room wants to explain it to her. When a woman is in the wrong, every guy in the room has to tell her she's in the wrong or why, etc. It's just, it dick slappery all over the place.
And we gotta get rid of discrimination.
At the same time, we get a reward.
If some chick wants to get laid, high five to her. Just like a guy that, boy, I banged this chick, he gets a high five. But who cares?
At the same time, I would say that we just got to establish, but define roles so people have roles. You know, we're entering a world where everything is open to interpretation, and it's fucking retarded, and people are getting excessive, and it's not stopping. It's like with science, everything will become interpretation, and suddenly I don't have arms and limbs. I have examples, holograms, etc.
It's some weird fucking
religion or something, and I'm babbling, I know, but that's, I'm trying to portray the stupidity of it. I'm failing maybe at that. Anyway, back in this game that we all gathered to play, let's get back.
So then Elfeshi dies.
Walks up and fondles thoracics. I'm just making passes.
That sounds good.
But
sounds
I put a healing potion.
I like where this game is going.
I rub some healing goo over his wounds.
Giving himself doesn't seem to accelerate it. It seems to just be contact with it.
I've avoided the fuck out of it because I don't bathe in goo from a container that's 500 years old. Just because it feels good to rub it on my body. Like other characters.
I just want to point out, you walked into
the
goo.
I collected it in the wild.
Right?
I walked
into
myself.
Yeah. So you're walking into the goo. The moment you do, you gain 5 hit points.
Through the boots.
Through your boots.
Well, fine. I won't pretend like I did that on purpose.
The coats against your boots permeates them, and you have wet feet now. That said, it also seems to dry like rubbing alcohol, and the gel form of it is what's keeping it there. As you step through it, and bits of it start to separate in the atmosphere, as it's now broken out of the chamber and time is passing, it seems that if it's not kept in a container, this is what's going to happen, is whatever is the fluid portion of it is evaporating, and the gelatinous part of it is separating.
Is the Nefeshi body still there or not?
It is, but it's degrading at a strangely accelerated rate. In the 10 minutes that you've been sitting here, the skin has already started to husk down, as the internals of it seem to be, you're not sure.
Did it have any experimentation done to it, or the cage?
So, looking over the container, you don't see anything immediately until you look under the corpse of Nalfeshi's. Or sorry, I forgot I had to jump out. So, looking into the basin, you see against the reflections of the broken glass, there seems to be a shape in the fluid, and coming closer, you see still. It's a deceased humanoid form, small humanoid form robust, suited in something.
Wait, what? The humanoid